And at any time, if that doesn't feel comfortable anymore, please feel free to remove the blocks and come straight into Savasana. We'll start our practice in the normal way, taking a few deep breaths in through the nose and out through the mouth. Feeling our bodies melt towards the earth. Noticing the contact of our bodies on the blocks or the mat underneath us. And running through a body scan from head to toe to get a sense of the mood and the energy of the body. Focusing today on the areas of strength and comfort. Noticing the areas of discomfort, but celebrating those areas that feel good and strong today. Possibly setting an intention for today's practice. The reason we came to the mat today. Possibly something mentally or physically we've been struggling with this week we want to address and tap into. Back to the sounds of the space around us, noticing the temperature of the room, the smells, and the beating of our hearts, possibly a little bit more powerful as we open our chests, linking our eyes open or keeping them closed, removing the blocks from underneath us, coming all the way into Savasana. Gently lowering ourselves down. Good. Floating our arms over our heads. Taking deep breaths into the lungs, and then on the exhale, we'll draw one knee up into our chest, hugging it. On the inhale, we'll float the arms and legs long. And on the next exhale, we'll bring the opposite knee into our chest, hugging it in. Floating through this motion, inhale, lifting and extending the arms and legs. Exhale, alternating sides, hugging the knee into the chest. Noticing the sensations in the hip flexors and the lower back. Being gentle. And moving to the flow of our breath. Noticing the lifting of the lower back and then it's pressing back into the mat on the exhale. Finding whatever depth to the poses that suit you. Maybe arching a little bit more each time we inhale. Thank you. one more on each side. Next inhale, we reach long, holding and arching the lower back, drawing the breath all the way through the nose, through the abdomen, and in through the lower back, noticing the sensations in the lower back as we have a gentle back bend. Expanding the lungs, the rib cage, and the abdomen laterally. Feeling our shoulder blades and back of the head pressing into the mat. And on the next exhale, we'll drop both knees into a tight little ball, lifting our head and our shoulders off the mat, wrapping our hands around the shins, slowly drawing the thighs closer to the abdomen with each exhalation. As any tension releases, in the hip flexors. Option to keep the head off the mat if that feels good on the neck. Option to lower it down. One more breath here. And then we'll float our feet back 90 degrees, hip width apart, planting the feet on the mat below. Maybe walking the shoulder blades down a little bit, and we'll come into a hip bridge, so palms are pressing into the mat. We'll take deep breaths in, and on the exhale, we'll lift the hips up, drawing the pelvis up, engaging the quadricep muscles, and go ahead and lower back down. We'll float up on the inhalation and down on the exhalation. Option here to add in some box breathing, holding at the top and bottom. And of course, there's the option to float our arms, floating them over the head as we lower the hips, and floating them back along our sides as we inhale. Finding a flow or a hold that suits you. Feeling the chin lower towards the chest as we lift the hips off the ground. Let's do two more. Keeping the knees stacked over top of the ankles. Go ahead and hug the knees back into the chest one more time. Notice any difference in the sensations, how they may have changed. Maybe our mood or energy is starting to calm. Good. Go ahead and extend the legs up over the hips. Flexing the feet, driving the heels up, pressing the knees back. And keeping our legs straight, go ahead and wiggle the feet, pointing and flexing. And with the right ankle, bringing it over the left knee, thread the needle. So hands come on top of the shin or cradle the foot option to bring the left arm around the foot and the right elbow around the right knee, whichever feels best for your body today. Lifting or keeping the head on the mat, again, your choice. Finding stillness or rocking side to side, if that feels good. And eagle the leg, so pressing the right leg over the left. The left foot will come to the outside of the mat and come into a twist, gentle twist of the spine. Extending the arms sideways from the shoulders. Once again, bringing our awareness to the breath. Drawing the breath all the way through into the lower back, down the left side of the body. Noticing any areas of comfort or discomfort. And staying present. Those areas of discomfort, noticing how the sensations change as we breathe into it. Bringing the legs back to center, untwining and untwisting them, hip width apart. Good. Once again, bringing the arms along our sides and stacking the legs all the way up over the hips. Ah, crick, crack, crick, crack. To the knee, threading the needle or cradling the whole left leg, wrapping the left arm around the left knee, right arm around the left foot, rocking or finding stillness here. Left foot farther over the right knee, crossing the legs into eagle, walking the right foot over to the edge of the mat, and go ahead and find your twist, lowering the knees to the left side, extending the arms from the shoulders. Again, breathing into any areas of possible discomfort where we may be hanging on to tension. Two more breaths. And on the next inhale, we'll bring our knees back to center again, releasing the left foot back to the earth. And let's go ahead and hug the knees in one more time. Cross crossing the right foot over the left. We're going to roll up into easy seated position, bringing our block underneath our glutes as flat as possible. Just elevating our hips for a deeper breath. Keeping our right foot in front of the left to start. Good. Rolling the shoulders. Just rolling backwards. Noticing the muscles in our faces soften or smiling. And go ahead and roll the shoulders forward, drawing them up towards the ears. Tall spine, as if there's a string attached to our head, drawing us up. Good. Finding stillness. On the inhale, we'll lift our arm. On the exhale, we'll lower it back down. So finding a little bit of an opening of the chest. And then we alternate sides on the next inhale. Using the opposite hand as leverage against the knee to start twisting the spine, looking back behind us, gently and slowly. Finding whatever range of motion you are able to. Next one, we'll fully rotate, keeping an open twist, inhaling, lowering our arm behind us, up on the fingertips, looking over the shoulder, breathing into the right side of the neck or the opposite side, whichever side feels like there's some tension held, blocked energy, breathing through it. Inhalation, we'll bring our arm all the way up. Exhaling, forward, good. Same thing on the other side, inhale, lifting. Wrapping it all the way around onto the fingertips, pressing the spine tall, looking over the shoulder. Noticing the sensations in this side of the neck, breathing into it. Two more breaths. And on the next inhale, we'll lift the arm all the way back up. And exhale, lower. Good. Switching the position of our feet. So left comes in front of right. Good. And bringing our hands to the knees, we'll do some butterflies. So on the inhale, we roll the shoulders, shoulder blades in and down. On the exhale, we round forward, curling the spine, chin to chest, floating through. Inhale, lifting the chest. Exhale, grounding the spine, creating space between each of the vertebrae. Using the knees as leverage as possible, or even the shins if that feels more comfortable.
noticing the back muscles light up, start to weaken. Two more. And staying at the bottom after the exhalation, continuing to round the spine. Chin is to chest. And a little neural flossing to the neck. Option to sway the head left to right if that feels good. Finding length from the tailbone all the way through to the crown of the head. As we breathe deeply, expanding the upper back, massaging along the spine. Three more just like that. Inhale, we'll slowly stack the vertebrae, coming back to a neutral spine. Inhaling, reaching the arms over the shoulders. Palms together. Inhale, reaching, extending, elongating. Exhale, over to the right side, gentle side bend. Finding the sit bones planted into the ground or the block underneath us. Three more big breaths into the left side of the lower back and side body. Inhale it. Exhale, let's round forward, gentle rotation. All the way over to the left. Bringing our arms back over the shoulders, palms are still together. Inhaling, reaching and elongating. And then over to the left. Finding grounding in our right sit bone into the block or the mat. It may want to lift. Finding the breath all the way through to any areas of discomfort. One more breath. And then we inhale, reaching. Exhale, we round forward in gentle rotation. Over to the left. And back to center. Alright. Coming back to a neutral spine, stacking the vertebrae. Deep breath in. And sigh it out. Noticing the shoulders releasing back down away from the ears. Let's remove our blocks. And before we come into staff pose, let's reach our arms all the way up one more time. Lowering the right arm onto the fingertips, extend it out from the side, and then gentle side body stretch, bending the right elbow, keeping the left sit bones into the mat, maybe walking the hand out. If the lower back starts to release, keeping the left arm over the ear. Go ahead and rotate the neck and the head as feels comfortable while breathing through to the left side body and lower back. Do a deep breath in and then exhale, we're going to round forward, walking our hands all the way out, finding placement for our hands in a supportive forward fold, maybe lowering down to our forearms, finding our block as needed to elevate to the ground.
option, of course, to sway left to right or to find stillness. Just listening to what our bodies need. The next inhale, we'll walk our hands up, stacking the vertebrae,
rolling the shoulders, and one more time, inhale, reaching all the way up over our shoulders. This time the left hand comes down to the earth, up on the fingertips, deep breaths in, and going over to the left, bending at the elbow, supporting, and breathing into the right side body. As possible, drawing the right shoulder back, keeping the sit bones firmly planted. Option, of course, is to lower that arm. Listen to your body and what it needs. One more big breath. Inhaling, and on the exhale, we round forward. Once again, walking the hands out, finding our blocks, whatever feels comfortable. Maybe sinking a bit lower this time. And bringing our awareness to the breath, noticing the rib cage expand laterally. And the head is hanging heavy. One more breath. And on the next inhale, we'll stack the vertebrae one at a time, walking the hands back. Rounding the shoulders. Bringing our feet in front of us, staff pose. Oh, let's just wiggle them out to stars. Feels good. Release that tension. Good. Go ahead and point and flex the feet once again. A little proprioception to the ankles. Yeah, good. So on the inhale, we're gonna lift the arms over the shoulders. On the exhale, we're going to come over to the left side, looking back towards the left hand. Inhale, lifting all the way back up. And exhaling over to the opposite side. And let's do four more just like that. Keeping the toes flexed. Lifting a little bit higher each time. And maybe bending forward a bit deeper. Noticing what's happening in the back of the legs. Drawing the chin into the chest on the exhale. Last one on each side. Last time, reaching all the way up on the inhale. And on the exhale, we're going to bend forward, bringing our knees in, grabbing onto our toes. Good. Drawing the shoulders back and down. Tucking just the lower ribs into the thighs. Good. Keeping a tall upper body, you are welcome to start slowly pressing the heels forward
But we're not rounding the spine here. We're actively engaging the upper back, shoulders. Keeping the lower ribs tucked into the thighs. Inching our way down. Exhalation, finding new depth. Honoring the state of our bodies, not comparing to others or how we may have been the last time we were in a staff pose. Working through any tension in the hamstrings, and the ligaments that run from the lower back through to the ankles. And go ahead and release the hands, straightening the legs, allowing the arms to fall naturally, keeping the feet flexed, chins to chest. Deep breaths here. Inhale, we'll stack the vertebrae along the shoulder side. Curling our right leg in towards the left thigh. Seated tree pose. Once again, keeping the left foot flexed. Inhaling, we're going to bring our left arm in towards the inner thigh. Inhaling, bringing our right arm up. Option to bring it over the ear. A little bit more of an intensity to the side body stretch here. Let's take our time to breathe through any discomfort. Not pushing too far, too fast. And of course, to bring the hand around behind the back. And let's float the right arm back down, holding our body in this side bend, floating the right arm, straightening it, palm is facing down. Go ahead and move the neck around the head, with the arm, maintaining some traction on the neck. Two more breaths. Inhale, lifting the arm back over the ear. Reaching a little bit taller. Pressing the right knee into the mat. Sit bones are still firmly planted. And go ahead and bring the right arm all the way over towards the left foot, pivoting our upper bodies. Keeping our foot flexed and finding a comfortable position for the head. Still breathing into the lower back on the right side. One more big breath. And on the inhale, we'll walk our torsos all the way back to center. Good. And we'll switch legs. Left leg comes all the way in. Right leg extends. Flexing the foot. Good.
judgement. Inhaling, lifting the left arm, bringing the right hand into the inner thigh, slowly side bending, keeping the foot flexed. And again, noticing what's happening on the left side. Finding position for the head, where we have some gentle traction on the neck. To explore any areas we may need extra time on and attention. And go ahead and float the left arm back parallel to the floor, finding that traction on the neck. Left arm back over the ear, inhale, maybe coming a little bit deeper into the side body. Inhale, we'll bring our left arm all the way over and back down to the right leg, pivoting the torso, keeping the foot flexed, noticing any tension we may be holding in our shoulders or our jaw. And continuing to breathe through to the left lower back. One more breath. And on the next inhale, we'll press ourselves back up, stacking the vertebrae. Good. And we're going to roll onto all fours. Gentle transition, bringing the hands under our shoulders. Knees under our chest. That doesn't work. Knees under our hips. We tried doing that on Thursday too. It didn't work so well. Good, finding our stability here, gripping the mat with our fingertips. We'll just run through gentle cat-cow, inhaling, lifting the tailbone, drawing the chest through the arms. And exhaling, rounding out, maybe curling the toes under our shins. Opening up the abdomen, drawing the shoulder blades back. As if we're drawing the mat towards our knees with our hands, strong engagement of the upper back, and then drawing the navel through to the ceiling as we gaze towards our feet. Deep breath here, holding ourselves in our rounded position. Two more. Option to hold here, option to come into down dog. Option, of course, to come into child's pose. We won't be here long, just a few breaths to find our
find a little length in the back of the body. Pedaling or finding stillness, depending on what you feel you need at this time. One more big breath wherever you are. And then we'll slowly lower back down or lift ourselves back into all fours. Flattening the feet behind us. Walking the hands out. And we're coming into eighth pointed touch. So lowering chest, chin, lifting the hips up, keeping the elbows into our stomach. Gentle back bend here. Drawing the shoulder blades back and down. Good. And go ahead and press the legs all the way back. Good. Keeping the hands at the sides of our ribs. Gentle cobra. Pressing feet into the mat, the thighs. Breathing into the lower back. And the shoulders down and back. And go ahead and lower. Take a deep breath in between. Giving the hands out onto the fingertips are oscillating cobra, but we're just going to hold at the top. Once again, pressing the tops of our feet into the mat, deep breaths in, we lift the chest off the earth, drawing the shoulders back a little bit more of a shoulder and chest opener here. You may feel this running down the front of the arm. Deep breath in between. Good. Keeping our left hand firmly planted just on the outside of the mat. We're going to lift our right leg off the mat. And rotate, pressing away with the right hand. Walking this time the left arm all the way out, extending the left arm. Getting into the left shoulder, upper arm and back, maybe even the neck as we look towards the right. Finding a placement for our right foot. Just checking in. Checking in with the sensations and the breath. Option, of course, to bring the right arm behind the back, interlacing the hands, finding a little additional intensity to the left shoulder and arm. Two more breaths. And then we'll slowly roll out of that, bringing the right hand back to the side of our body, rolling our right leg. Good. And let's go ahead straight over to the other side. So right arm comes long, extending from the shoulder. We gaze over to the opposite side. Left hand is up on the fingertips. We lift our left leg. And slowly rotate back, opening our right shoulder and arm. Option at any time to bring the left hand behind the back, grabbing onto the elbow or interlacing the hands. finding whatever feels most beneficial to you. More breaths. You can be getting a little bit deeper. And then we'll release the arms. The left hand comes back to the side of the mat and slowly we rotate the hips, extending the legs long. Good. Deep breaths in between. And reset. And this time we're going to bring our hands underneath our chest. This may be intense enough. Option, of course, is to reach the hands as wide as possible. And then slowly letting the chin fall over the upper arm. Breathing through any blocked energy. Not only are we creating some traction on the neck, but we're opening up the upper arms and the upper back. But it can be quite intense. So let me be gentle. Staying with that discomfort, breathing through it, noticing how it transforms. The body start to relax. One more breath. And lift our heads. Untwist the arms, bringing them back underneath us. Loading the arms along the sides of our body before switching sides, lifting our feet. Option to come into upward bow, reaching back to the feet, not twisting the spine to get there. Keeping the knees hip width apart as possible. And the option, of course, is to lift the thighs and the chest off the mat, opening the chest and the upper arms. Finding a pose that works for you. Feels comfortable. Coming back down when you're ready. When your core pose. One more deep breath to reset. Then we'll bring our arms back underneath our chin, opposite direction. Arm over top. And slowly letting the chin fall over the arms. Intensity, knowing that it will change. Focusing on the discomfort. It will run away. he doesn't like to be focused on. Discomfort is used to being avoided. Hopefully starting to feel a little bit of a relaxation, a release of tension. Two more big breaths. And let's untwist ourselves. Bring our hands underneath us one more time. Sphinx pose. Plant your hands. Elbows are under our shoulders. Lifting and drawing the chest up. Once again, drawing the shoulders down and back. Breathing into the lower back. Strong upper body. Releasing a little bit of the energy. Go ahead and rotate the neck and head left to right. Finding stillness. Press ourselves all the way back into child's pose. Bringing the knees underneath our hips. Sinking back, finding our blocks. Bringing it underneath our foreheads. Arms are alongside of the block. I'm just taking a moment here to roll the forehead left to right on top of the block. Activating our vagus nerve, bringing a little mental clarity. One more breath here. Stacking the vertebrae one at a time, coming up into rock pose.
Rolling the shoulders back with our fists on either side of the sacrum. Go ahead and just gently arch the lower back, lifting the chest, drawing the elbows towards one another as possible. Of course, to come into a full camel if this isn't intense enough for you. Noticing the sounds around us and that gentle breeze. And go ahead and release. Resetting the spine, bringing our hands in front of us, coming up onto toes pose, curling the toes underneath our shins. Making sure our pinkies are engaged, spreading them out so all five toes on the mat. Good. Now we'll finish off with some eagle arms, so left arm under right. Bringing the palms together as possible. And on the inhale, we'll lift the arms up. And on the exhale, we'll lower. Finding a range of motion that suits you. floating to the rhythm of our breath. Release the arms, pressing our hips up, tapping out the feet. Good. Staying present with that discomfort. Come into a camel pose here. So, option, of course, to bring the hands in front of us, engaging the glutes, pressing the pelvis forward. Option to reach back and grab the heels if that feels comfortable for today. Using the thigh muscles to lower us down, not twisting the spine. Two more breaths. Once again, using the thigh muscles. Good. Coming back into toes pose. Eagling the arms the opposite way. Yes. Right arm under left. Palms together. And on the inhale, we lift. On the exhale, we lower. Again, floating with our breath. Noticing the sensations in the tops of our feet have possibly changed. Maybe not as intense as it was the first time. Tension we're holding in our jaws, letting it go. One more big breath here. Releasing the arms, releasing the feet, tapping them out as needed. And then coming back into rock pose with our hands on our thigh muscles, palms are facing up, rolling the shoulders back. Good. Option to bring your hands to heart center, pressing the palms together, deep breath into the nose, and let's sigh it out through the mouth. One more like that. Lowering the shoulders away from the ears. Gentle expression on our faces. Taking a moment to reflect on any intention we may have set at the beginning of our practice. Noticing a change in our energy or the mood of our body. And thanks for the opportunity to practice this community, the glorious weather, and our families for encouraging us to get to the mat today. Filling our hearts with gratitude, breathing through our heart the last breath here. Blinking our eyes open. Namaste. Thank you for joining.